AC Jimbo himself, James Richardson.
Welcome everybody to Football Weekly Live in London. We're here to answer your footballing questions, particularly if your footballing question is, what would it look like if Inspector Montalbano, Paul Giamatti, Lawrence Llewellyn Bowen and Cole Meaney made a boy band?
I listen to it on the way into work and the way home from work. I've got quite a stressful job and it chills you out because it's talking about things you kind of talk to your mates about.
I like hearing kind of the views on the weekend's action. I like kind of the sense of anticipation on the Thursday about what's coming up.
It's quite informative and funny at the same time. It's good balance between humour and content.
And you get a great depth of analysis.
I'm only here for the puns.
James Richardson's puns.
I love the banter. Yes.
The banter.
Banter.
And the gossip, I suppose, about football. That's what I really like.
We had Matthew Flamini on the... He was actually quite suave and quite handsome, wasn't he?
Quite compelling, quite soulful, tender eyes.
Yeah.
You sense, though, don't you, that he would be rough when the time came?
Me and my mates who work with you said as soon as there's a live event, we're definitely going to go.
I just saw it as an option on the Guardian.
I guess I've been listening for 7 or 8 years now, and in part you want to see what they look like. What do these people look like?
Definitely become part of your routine, so to come and actually see them and see them speak live and stuff is quite cool.
What's the best goal the panel has ever seen live?
Some of you may remember a footballer named Scott Sinclair.
Traylon Ross Dellas,
Colin Alcide.
I was there when Big George Weah did his run against Verona.
Yeah, I might go with that one, I think.
We're all here for Richardson, really. It's a horrific man crush, I think, that goes for both of us.
He doesn't try and dominate the actual chat, whereas a lot of interviewers these days tend to say it's their show. He actually is a very good conductor of information around the table.
I must admit, I do enjoy Barry's contributions.
Barry Glendenning.
Is it Brian Glendenning?
Good knowledge, but delivered in a fun way and not in a boring way.
I like the fact he deliberately provokes football fans as well, which is good. More people should do that, I think.
I think he's the funniest. And just kind of, he has the distance to it, so he doesn't take it too seriously. He's always a bit like, yeah, I can joke about it. It's not serious, it's just a game.
I have the lineups here on my tablet. The Arsenal lineup is there. I didn't quite catch the Southampton one, so I've just written Matt Letizier.
Matt Letizier was 20 years younger and 8 stone lighter. Would he get into this Southampton side?
People pay a lot of money to go and watch football in their leisure time. Mm. If Matt Letizier is available to be on the field, he has to play. No. And he pulled Marilyn from home and away.
Oh, really?
Really?
Yeah. Sort of cranks him up a notch in my view.
But what goes on behind the scenes of a transfer deal? Who decides which players are targeted and why? Why do deals collapse?